Tomás, píllalo. Pasa y pregúntale por qué no vale el ejemplo de la mano.
He wants you to explain why the orange example is a bad example.
Okay, muy bien. El naranja. The example of the ugly orange demonstrates that someone could find a solution to each person's needs. You need the middle, the pulp, and I need the orange. Juice, so yeah, okay. But we could come to that point without ever talking about it. A mediator could say, well, I find out your needs, I find out my needs, and therefore the best solution is to peel it and you get one and I get the other. But what if tomorrow we have an issue about something else, and it's not an orange, it's a conflict of a different kind? Have we learned anything from working on this issue that carries over to tomorrow about how to understand each other or how to express what we need in certain ways? And perhaps the better solution is that you get the whole thing and I get nothing, because what you're going to do is more important than I am. And so why should a mediator say, no, we split, you get one, I get the other? Maybe I want to say, no, todos, you need the skin, but you can have the center too and do it with what you will. Why isn't that possible? Why isn't that even a good possibility that comes out of our interaction? So it's more about solving the problem than about our interaction.
I'd like to have a general picture of what transformative mediation training is. Mm-hmm. What do you do? Who participates? What's your methodology? Which objectives underlies the training?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the training is a training which starts with understanding the theory of transformation of conflict. So in the first part of the training, we want people to understand how to see conflict through the eyes of empowerment and recognition, so that anybody can tell if a conflict is moving productively, where is the movement towards empowerment and the movement towards recognition. It's important to see that in any conflict situation. Secondly, it's important to experience the value of empowerment and recognition. So we have activities and exercises which are not about mediation, but about personal experiences with empowerment and with recognition. So that if a mediator is going to produce or work with empowerment and recognition, they should value it. They should have a sense in themselves that, yes, this matters, this is important. So we work with that. Then we work with moment to moment how to identify opportunities to work with empowerment and recognition. We don't do whole role plays. We don't teach phases of mediation. The skill is listening to an interaction between two people, taking it moment by moment and saying, okay, could I work here to help this person become more empowerment or reach more empowerment? Or could I help these people at this point work with recognition? So you have to understand where are the opportunities and then how you go about working with them. You also have to understand the timing, when you would interrupt to work with something versus when you would let the parties continue to interact. And part of that skill is to be able to hear whether empowerment or recognition is going on, even if you're not.